Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, we're going to take a look at what your competitors are doing with their Google Ads search campaigns. I'll show you how to use the advertising toolkit in Semrush to see who's bidding on particular keywords and the ad messages they're running. This is a great way to get ideas for your own campaigns. I'll also walk you through the Ads Launch Assistant. This feature makes it simple to create and manage Google Ads campaigns by automatically researching keywords and generating ad copy. Before we jump in, I want to thank Semrush for sponsoring this video. If you'd like to learn more about the Advertising Toolkit, you'll find a link in the description below. Okay, to start, we're going to use the Ads History tool to do some competitive research. This will give us ideas we can use for our ad copy and calls to action. Let's navigate to Ads History. We can now enter a keyword to see if our competitors have been running ads for the keyword. I want to refresh my ads for my Google Analytics course, so I'm going to enter GA4 training to see what other people are including in their ads. I'm going to leave US selected, but you can change this to view ads that have been shown in other countries. Okay, now let's click search. For the keyword GA4 training, there are three advertisers listed. On the left side of the table, we can see the previous month, and this shows us the website with the most paid traffic listed first. We can then see their total estimated advertising spend for their advertising traffic and the total number of keywords they're bidding on. I want to highlight that the traffic, price, and keyword metrics show the total for each advertiser. So the values we see here are not just for the single keywords we entered into the Ad History tool. And even though the numbers cover overall activity, they're still helpful because they can guide your top-level budget if you want to compete with that advertiser. I'll show you how to get budget insights at the keyword level in a moment. Before we look at that, we can also start to get ideas for our ads using the tool. Moving to the right of the table, we can see the previous 12 months listed. This lets us see the different ads each competitor has been running. And the number shows us the highest position the advertiser has reached in that particular month. We can click on these to see the ads. This is really useful for understanding the messages and calls to action competitors are using. You can use this to help refine your own ads. For the first advertiser, we can see they repeat the word experts, so we might want to think about including that in our ads. They're also writing their ads using where and we, so first person plural, and they use the word together, so we should consider this too. The second advertiser includes the phrase newest version, the range of topics covered, and some features of their offer. And the third advertiser repeats the phrases troubleshoot common problems, close knowledge gaps, and go further in their ads. So there seems to be a focus on solving pain points with their offer. So we can use the Ad History tool to understand how competitors are presenting their offers to our target audience. We can then use these insights to inform our own ads. Another thing that's really useful is we can view the landing pages used for each of the ads. To do this, you can either click the headline to open the landing page in a new tab, or you can right-click and copy the landing page URL. This means you can see if advertisers are using dedicated landing pages for their Google Ads campaigns or even changing their landing pages. If you want to understand how much budget a competitor is allocating to the keyword, you can also find this in the Advertising Toolkit. To do this, let's click the value in the Ads Keywords column for a particular competitor. The advertising research tool opens and it loads details for the individual competitor we selected. At the top of the Positions tab, we can see the total number of keywords they're targeting, their estimated traffic from paid ads, and the estimated average monthly advertising cost. Semrush also keeps track of what each advertiser is doing in different countries. So we're currently looking at this advertiser's estimated advertising spend for the United States, but we can change this. Let's select United States and change this to United Kingdom. The metrics and table update, and we can now see the estimate for their monthly advertising spend in the UK. Below the trends graph, we can then see a breakdown of all the keywords they're targeting. And if we want to find out how much they are spending for a particular keyword, we can find the keyword in the table or use the filter option at the top. Let's filter for GA4. We can now see the keywords, traffic, and total cost metrics update at the top. And the table now shows us a breakdown for the keywords. This includes costs and costs percentage, so you can understand how much budget they're allocating to the keywords. You can then check this against your advertising spend for the keywords in your Google Ads account. Now let's select the Ads History tab. This shows us keywords the advertiser appeared on over the last 12 months. And like the Ad History tool, we can also view the different ads they used. This report is particularly useful because you can identify when the advertiser is showing ads for particular keywords. You might find they've targeted the keyword every month, or maybe they only show ads for the keywords at particular times of the year. Again, we can see the top paid position they achieved each month. And we can click on a value to then see the ads that were displayed. And like we did previously, we can also add a filter. Let's enter Analytics to filter the report. We can then make a note of any terms we're not currently targeting and add them to our Google Ads account. Now that we've covered how to use the advertising toolkit to find competitor messages and keywords, let's put those insights into action by creating a new campaign. To do this, we're going to use the Ads Launch Assistant that simplifies campaign setup. Let's select Get Started. I've already been testing out this tool, so we can see there's an existing folder called Loves Data. And this contains two campaigns I created. To show you all of the steps, let's create a new folder. To do this, let's click Create New Folder. Now we can enter our business name. I'm going to enter Loves Data. And we can enter our website's domain. Now let's click Create. And let's click Set Up Campaign. Next, we need to sign in to our existing Google Ads account. Okay, now we need to authorize access. Because the advertising toolkit connects to your own Google Ads account, it means you can manage your campaigns in Semrush or in Google Ads. This also means you maintain control and ownership of your ads. If you haven't created a Google Ads account yet, you can find a link to my tutorial in the description. And let's click Complete Setup. Now we need to select our Google Ads account. And let's click Connect. Now let's click Continue. Next, we need to name our campaign. I'm going to call this campaign GA4 Course Semrush Search. This makes it clear what I'm advertising, that I created the campaign using Semrush, and it's a search campaign. Now we need to confirm the language, and we need to enter the landing page on our website. I'm going to enter the URL for my Google Analytics course. Next, we need to enter the location or locations we want to target. And for the campaign type, we can choose between search campaign or smart campaign. Selecting search campaign means you'll be creating a standard Google Ads search campaign, while selecting smart campaign will create a Google Ads smart campaign. Overall, smart campaigns are designed to simplify campaign creation and management. Smart campaigns can also display your ads on Google search results, Google Maps, YouTube, and Gmail. So if you want to get up and running quickly and get broader coverage, you can choose this option. When testing out both types of campaigns, I found the smart campaign targeted broader and more general terms people were searching for. So this type of campaign might send less relevant traffic to your website. However, because keyword targeting was broad, the cost per click was lower compared to the search campaign. If you want more control and more precise keyword targeting, I would consider creating a search campaign. I'm going to select search for this campaign. Now let's click Generate Ad Campaigns. The Ads Launch Assistant will now automatically generate keywords, callouts, site links, and ads for our campaign. And we can adjust all of these elements along with the daily budget and start date. I'm going to adjust the keywords slightly, so let's click Edit. I'm going to remove any keywords that are not relevant to my offer and landing page. You can also change the keyword match type for each keyword, generate more keywords, and add your own keywords to the campaign. I'm going to add a couple of keywords that we found while researching competitors earlier. Now let's click Save Changes. You have the option of adding negative keywords. Below this, we can see the callouts that have been automatically created. Callouts let you include additional information with your ad. I'm going to adjust the callouts, so let's click Edit. You can click the trash can icon to remove callouts. And you can click the lock icon to keep callouts you like. You can then click Generate Callouts to automatically create new callouts. When you're happy, click Save Changes. Once you've reviewed everything, you can click Launch Campaign. Your campaign will now be created in your Google Ads account. Once your ads are up and running, you will be able to view your reports in the Ads Launch Assistant, and you can also view your campaign directly inside your Google Ads account. Take a moment to try the Semrush Advertising Toolkit. I've included a link in the description below this video. And if you'd like me to create a video covering the reports and how to manage your campaign, please let me know in the comments. To learn more about Google Ads, please subscribe to this channel and check out the extra resources in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.